Hello, people. It's 7:19 p.m. and it's July 21st, 2018, I gather. We're going to have a fruitful discussion, people. I'm going to try to do a synopsis on two of the types of the videos that I made plenty of, like Epic Truths and Ghost and Bones Revealed Truth. Let me see. Also, Apotheosis. I'm going to try to do a synopsis that will wrap those all of those videos up in one shot. Now, in order for you to kind of like understand my videos, in order for you to comprehend where I'm coming from with my videos, you would have to believe in the advancements that has been covered up, which would be time travel technology or time bending technology. You would have to have an understanding of that, and you would have to have an understanding of how we're actually this earth is actually sort of like a hell region. This is the underworld. You would have to understand those things, and you would also have to understand that they've been having the technology to peer into other timelines. And that's where all these theories are coming up concerning Jesus Christ with Mary Magdalene being married. And it's like, just like that movie, Mr. Nobody. Several ways this man's life could have turned out, or several ways my life could be. Well, I'm going to read these scriptures to you, and I want you to compare, because I did say something to you about not about the New Jerusalem and the rebuilding of that New Jerusalem coming out of heaven and all of this stuff. You can't go for that, because if you compare Ezekiel 28 to Revelations 21, you're going to see that you're literally rebuilding Lucifer. So I'm just giving you some points, people, to go by, okay? So let me read Habakkuk. Let's read this. And I'm going to put the camera here. Let's see if I can find Habakkuk. So you can understand that if you don't have an understanding of how advanced this tech is, you're not going to understand things. All right, let's read Habakkuk 1, 15. That's not it. It was Habakkuk 1:5. There we go. Yes. Look among the nations and watch. Be utterly astounded, for I will work a work in your days which you would not believe though it were told you. Okay, now it's also quoted in Acts 13. Let's go there. Then it's saying, work a work, you will be astounded. And it's going to be quoted here too. 41. There it is. Behold, you despisers, marvel and perish. For I work a work in your days, a work which you will by no means believe, though one were to declare it to you. See? You're not going to believe it. I'm declaring to you what is actually taking place far as this dimensional time bending tech, them being able to go back into the past and see things. And I'm about to show you at Ezekiel. I'm not going to read it. I'm just going to let this camera scan here so that you can see that Lucifer, Satan, Samuel, these beings have different names, but they're just one being. Sometimes it's one being, but different manifestations. Like I told you, Jesus Christ, his 12 and 13, that would have been all of him. All of those are his manifestations. Okay? Hanging somebody on a cross. This is the grievance here. This planet is predominantly a planet where people and beings are put to do penance. Okay? Penance is your sentence in the material world. Your rebirth into a material body or a physical body. Well, this is where we're going to discuss about the saints, because y'all have interfered with the work of saints. Lord Yahshua was a saint. Okay? Maitreya is a saint, a Buddha. He's doing work here, and this is his last birth. Beings that don't want to ever have to take material birth again are here, as well as the Nephilim that they have dug up, got their DNA, and probably recreated them. These giants. See, they want an end-of-day scenario to transpire here, where these creatures, big giants, are able to devour the earth, okay? And you have to understand, people, this is considered the underworld, all right? This is like the Naraka, the Patalas, where whatever happens to you, I don't like the idea of karmic, but they feel these deities, like the Sumerian deities, these are underworld deities, Egyptian deities, these are the underworld overseers or overlords. They feel they have the right to exact punishment upon you. But let's get to Ezekiel here so you can see where you're going to, if you go along with this, it's like rebuilding Satan. Now here God is in 13. See, that's Ezekiel chapter 28, and there at 13. See where it says you were in Eden, the garden of every. See the stones. See where they you see these stones, okay? See, he was nothing but an anointed cherub, and he resided on a mountain. Okay, you see that? The fiery stones. So you're not going to be able to rebuild. All of this has been to rebuild Lucifer. Now let's go to 21 of Revelations. Let's see. All right. Y'all think I'm cruel and mean, huh? Now see where it's right here in Revelations 21? No. Is it 20 or 21? I think it's 22. Yeah, it is. There it is. It is. It is there. It's in 21. There it is. Let's see. This is all about terraforming minerals and rebuilding Lucifer. So he can. Let me see what it is. There it is. See? And he came away and showed me a great sea, new holy Jerusalem descending out of heaven from having the glory of God. Now, when I told y'all this is very unnatural and satanic, because there cannot ever not be suns and moons, okay? The suns and the moons are God's witnesses. They're the keepers of time for this realm. So when it's talking about, and I'm going to show you when it's saying no sun, no moon. I'm only giving y'all little tidbits of my knowledge of what I've come to piece together. See where it's saying? There, the great city, the gates, the chill. Look. So all of this sacrificing of people has been actually and going in districts where you shouldn't, stealing biostones, has been to rebuild Lucifer. Now let's see where it's going to say the stones. There, see? There it is. The foundation of the wall of the city was adorned with all the precious stones. Jasper, sapphire. See? All of that. Now here it is. The city had no need of the sun or the moon to shine in it. The lamp, lamb is its light. So you see what that's saying, huh? That means you sacrifice a saint, Yahshua. I'm telling you people, this is not good. Now you can believe your lies if you want to. That's going to be on y'all. But there will be King of the Earth will burn. There shall be no night there. For this realm, people, that's not going to be possible because life is cyclic. You understand me? Life is it's done by yugas and kalpas. So when it talks about the kings in these gods and demigods and semi-demigod beings, these beings are actually your ancestors. Now you understand? The preachers are the fathers. They're your ancestors. So, like I said before, you're going to have to, I don't know, this is deep. Now, what I also wanted to explain to you about the different time travel, time bending technology where they can peer into these different scenarios of people's lives. They always talk about Mary Magdalene being married to Lord Yahshua or Jesus Christ, right? Well, we get into these arguments about these things, and sometimes they're very futile. But Mary Magdalene was a married woman. She was married before she even met Christ. Okay? She was a very wealthy woman who was married to a man, but she inherited her wealth from her father. And her husband, because she was barren and didn't bear him an heir, he disowned her, kicked her out of her own estate. Magdala was an estate, you know, a very providence. And I'm not really sure that it was in Palestine. I think it was in Spain. Well, she was disinherited from her own inheritance. And this is why I'm telling you, y'all have harmed saints. Okay? You cannot do that. You cannot go out of these districts of North and South Pole and go into these ancestral abodes and destroy people's inheritance like you have done with this technology, USDOD and NATO and DARPA. Okay? Well, anyway, she was disinherited from her husband. He took on a younger wife so he can have an heir, took her property, and this is where this is all coming from, with land and these disputes about land. You need to know the real story of what some of these characters that are in these Bible, because they done lied to y'all about history. Well, she was a healer also, meaning she was able to heal people. There's a tribe, like they say, of Marys. Mary's really Kumari. A Kumari is a healer, okay? Well, there were other Marys in the Bible as well. Mary, Martha, and Jesus' mother, Mary. These were all healers, okay? Well, anyway, she was a healer, Mary Magdalene. Mary Magdala, from Magdala. She came across, she was thrown out of her estate by her husband named Ezra, and She went to go get help from the Romans, okay? She had friends because she was very wealthy and somewhat well-known. She had friends. When she tried to get help from them, they solicited her. So at some point in her life, she did take on to prostitution to make a living for herself. But at one point, they raped her. Roman soldiers raped her, and I think that's how she became demon-possessed, the same way with Mia got gang raped. And when people are raped by things they shouldn't, gang raped, even little children, things can possess you. You understand me? You get possessed because it's such a cruel thing. And she was a saint. You understand? Well, she wanted to die. Christ found her. And he healed her. But at one point, she couldn't stand men because of what her husband had done. All right? So y'all need to know the real truth of some of this. Well, she became a disciple. She took on the message of Christ. And y'all have actually, when Christ was just on a mission, because he was doing penance here too. Do you understand? When saints are doing penance here, you should not interfere with their spiritual path or their spiritual walk. Whether you be a Christian, a Muslim, a Buddhist, a Hindu. When someone feels the need to pray or live in solitude, you need to leave them alone. Okay? Yes, there is a problem with organized religion and a lot of money being made through organized religion. But when you see a real person that is spiritually off to themselves and taking on a fate and not associating really with any organization, but yet they're very spiritual in their concepts and in the way they live, you need to leave them alone, okay? This is where this mind reading technology, that's why this realm has to be, this got to be removed from this realm, because it interferes with spiritual advancement. It interferes with people's spirituality, okay? On a very, very large, in a very, very bad way, too. So, that's what I wanted to expound upon. Ghost and bones reveals the truth. You understand me? Christ was doing penance here. Lots of people are doing penance here. I also don't recommend you even look upon the fathers in the Catholic Church as fathers, because they're not your actual ancestors. Your preterists are your ancestors. So a lot of this is going to get straightened out soon, you know? It's going to be straightened out soon. Because their whole objective now is to have a war between demons and angels, demonic entities, for an end-day scenario. And that is exactly what's happening, because this is the underworld, you know? And I'm here to tell you people that those Nephilim giants are real, okay? They're real. I'm here to tell you that this scenery tech is real, and that we do have semi-machine type people already on this earth now, which are Borgs or cyborgs. So y'all have a blessed day today, people. Have a nice day. And I'm feeling very thankful because I've got 5 fig trees in my neighborhood. They even have in the Bible how they say Christ cursed the fig tree. Well, tell Lord Yahshua, Jody's got 5 fig trees in her yard that I'm surrounded by, and I love it. I really do. Have a good evening, people.